Good morning, student. This is our Star Media Ports YouTube channel. This is for only for government school student to get through NEET seat. For the purpose only, we are going to be conducting this coaching class. We will plan to take that coaching up to the May of 2021. Listen, all of you, we will go to the class directly. See that this is a model question. The last year question we will discuss in this session. Identify the wrong statement with the reference to the transport of oxygen. This is a question. You have to find out a wrong statement of the four. Listen, first option, the partial pressure of carbon dioxide can interfere with oxygen binding with hemoglobin. So this is a right statement, I think, because between the pressure, alveoli as well as blood tube, blood vessels, the partial pressure of carbon dioxide and oxygen is exchange is take place. That's why it is a correct statement. Second one, the higher concentration of hydrogen plus higher hydrogen ion concentration in alveoli favor the formation of oxyhemoglobin. See, the word oxyhemoglobin is there. Oxyhemoglobin means the hemoglobin is a respiratory pigment present in the blood cells. So if the alveoli contain lot of oxygen, the blood vessels waiting for oxygen, if the concentration of oxygen ion and RBC concentration gradient is there, then only it's going to be formed the oxyhemoglobin. Here unwantedly they given hydrogen ion is there. So we will pass on next option, then only we will decide that. Third one, low partial pressure of carbon dioxide in alveoli favor of the formation of the oxyhemoglobin. So binding of the, so this is also I think a correct one. Low partial pressure of carbon dioxide in alveoli. Alveoli means in lungs they have air like structure, that is called alveoli. The alveoli contain less amount of carbon dioxide, then the formation is take place. And the binding of oxygen with the hemoglobin is mainly related to partial pressure of oxygen. So these three and all related to the respiration or transporting of oxygen. Respiration is a related terms. This one is not related in this post statement. So you have to keep it in your mind. Take it is a correct answer. Two is a wrong statement. That's why it is correct answer. Second question, which of the following refer to the correct example of organism which have evolved due to the changes in environment brought about by anthropogenic action? Listen, this is a very important word. Anthropogenic means the action influenced by the human being and the environment or organism, that is called anthropogenic. Man-made destruction, that is called anthropogenic action. So according to the anthropogenic destruction, due to the change of the environment brought a new species. So according this, you have to take the correct example of the four choices. See, Darwin's Finches of the Galapagos Island. That is one option. And second one is herbicide resistant weeds. This is also herbicide, and also man is going to be put the herbicide, and after that it's going to be resistant for herbicides. So that another one is drug resistant eukaryotes. Eukaryotes means we know that the true nucleus is present, the organism is called a eukaryote. That is organism is going to be resist to the drug. This is one causes. And the fourth one is man created breeds of domesticated animals like dog. So these and all we have to take what are the anthropogenic actions. So we will take the answer B one is correct. The herbicide is going to be made by the man, and C also drug resistant, also man made things, and also man created breeds. These three is man made action. It's going to be give another species or evolution. So that's why answer is B, C and D is the correct answer. Third question, which of the following is not an inhibitory substance governing seed dormancy? Seed, you have to keep it in your mind. Two word is there here, inhibitory substance. So the inhibitory means it's going to be break down, or it's going to be suppress the growth. That is called the inhibitory substance governing seed dormancy. Seed dormancy means the germination of the seed, it's going to be rest some period. That is called seed dormancy. If you awake the seed for germination, you have to put some chemicals on this. That is called inducer. That here the question is not a inhibitory substance for seed dormancy. This is a question you have to find out. This is one is abscisic acid. This is a inhibitory substance. And phenolic acid, this is also inhibitory substance. And para ascorbic acids, also inhibitory substance. So which one is not a inhibitory substance means the gibberellic acid is a not a inhibitory substance. So it's going to be seed dormancy, it's awaken. This is a correct answer. Keep it in your mind. Next question, match the following. Match the following. Here column 1 is there, column 2 is there. And column 1, they have the disease. Column 2, they have the causative agents. Here, the typhoid is a one disease. Here, the matching the sentence is there. And pneumonia is another disease. And filariasis, another disease, malaria is there. So in the causative agent, Eucheria, Plasmodium, and Salmonella, Haemophilus. So these are the sentences there. So you have to match the following. Typhoid, Salmonella type A. Salmonella type A. Here the A, B, C, D is there. For A, for a typhoid, the option 1 is 3, second one, second and fourth and 1. So the typhoid, Salmonella type A is a causative agent for a typhoid. So the option is there, first option is there, third, other option is there is no third. So it may be first one is correct answer. First one is correct answer, typhoid for Salmonella type A. So this is one answer. Another one is pneumonia. Pneumonia is the causative agent of Haemophilus. Haemophilus is a pneumonia disease causative agent. So this is B. And filariasis, this is the causative agents is Eucheria is a causative agent. Another one is malaria. Plasmodium vivax is a malarial agent. So this is the correct answer, keep it in your mind. Fifth question, select the correct event that occur during the inspiration. So keep it in your mind, inspiration. So respiration is two events is there, inspiration and expiration. Expiration, what are the muscles involved? And inspiration, what are the muscles are involved? That is a question here. The contraction of the diaphragm. So the contraction means, inspiration means the air taken inside. So the volume must be increased. So the contraction of a diaphragm only, the volume must be increased. Followed that, the contraction of the external intercostal muscles and external intercostal muscle means, here the external intercostal muscle, the rib cage is there. External intercostal muscle means the outside the rib cage, they connected muscle to ribs. It is called external intercostal muscles. So here the inside the one muscle is going to be connect the rib cage, that is called the internal intercostal muscles. So inspiration means you have to keep it in your mind, diaphragm and external intercostal muscles is going to be involved. So here the contraction of external intercostal muscles and pulmonary volume decreases means not at all happening in the inspiration. So intrapulmonary pressure increases. Intrapulmonary also is not suitable for this. So correct answer is A and B alone is responsible for inspiration. So student must be keep it in your mind. These are the sample question. You have to practice more MCQ from the NEET question. You have to get through the NEET exam. We will meet again one more set of question in next class. Thank you very much.